That was like the perfect.
Baby's
not impressed.
Good. All right. Hello. Welcome to another episode of Retro Monogatari. This is like episode 14 now, maybe 14-ish. Having some trouble getting the tonight's game to work. This is one of the Famicoms. This is Famicom Prime. I've got a spare there.
Pull it.
Oh, Famicom number 3 has a broken eject button. So I've got a little note there to remind me. All right.
So enjoy the baby while you wait for
it. Next game is Bomber King. Game 1 of 2 is Bomber King. We might have some bonus games later on to memorialize the Super Game Boy, which we picked up.
I'll be RB.
Switching out the console.
Thank you.
Oh, that's not quite there, but it's promising. So one of the best parts. Just trying to get the broken old technology to work. Oh man, I have to step backwards. Hudson presents Stripes. Hey William, how you doing?
Great.
This is William. William, say hi.
He's a baby.
Maybe we should start with the other game and then come back to this one.
Did you eat the seeds?
No, I put them on a plate.
I eat the seeds. I'm not going to pick them out.
Don't pick them out.
What a watermelon is going to grow in your gut. You'll be sorry.
Yeah, and then 9 months later you'll give birth to a watermelon.
I
might be a lost cause. Oh.
Can you still have a magic touch?
Nothing?
You gotta restart it. I mean, power off and power on. With my magic touch.
Your magic touch makes everything black.
It's on.
Hudson presents.
Hey, it's getting better. Because of the magic touch.
Was that a beep? Was that somebody's watch or was that the game?
There's so many seeds.
Like I said, the best part.
The seeds?
No, the best part of retro video games.
It would be in the picture, but there was a Super Famicom in my seat.
Oh, that's just a regular Famicom.
Oh, sorry.
Don't be putting on airs. You could, like, stand behind it.
You're stupid to me.
Alright, I'm gonna cycle back through consoles. Bomber King! He looks so cool. Look at that. He's like a dude. And there's a robot skull. And some stuff.
Surprisingly, when I was a kid, I didn't like watermelon.
You didn't like watermelon?
Yeah.
Well, it's basically just flavored water, right?
Yeah.
I guess you gotta plug it in first, huh?
Now I'm like.
I guess so.
Now I'm a watermelon for that.
So, if this is your first show, our purpose is to dig up these old, cool, weird video games that never made it to North America. And maybe if you feel nostalgic about those old Nintendo consoles, you might like to see a weird, bizarro world version of a bunch of those tropes.
Hey,
from early on.
It's working!
Yeah, alright, now I need to take the controllers out without jostling the cartridge.
Is this two player?
Well, it's open. Cool, alright, we've got a red planet, maybe it's Mars. Ooh, that's beautiful.
That is beautiful.
Look at that. I bet you we're gonna blow it up.
Damn, some nice graphics.
Oh, a bird!
So. By the way, I wrote the baby's name in kanji.
It says, Wiriyamu. The kanji, each character stands for something. Maggie, would you like to...
Rain, control, hometown, knitting.
Knitting. Hometown.
Yeah, I messed up. It's hometown.
Oh, okay. All right. Is this it? No, this is preview. Start!
Oh, it's one player.
All right, we're going in our Millennium Falcon to Mars.
My kanji means easy.
Let's see.
Actually,
they just start us off on a bunch of power-ups. That's pretty kind.
My kanji means reassurance to be tempting.
A button is shoot your lasers. Oh, my energy went down a little there.
Am I in camera?
You are not currently in camera.
Yay, Bobby.
Is this... Am I gonna... Yeah. Oh.
Ooh.
Ooh. So, this is...
It's like Bomberman.
Yeah, it's definitely got some Bomberman elements. Cool. I goofed. Let's try that again.
Maybe it's Red Dwarf, the video game.
Yeah.
It's actually Bomber King, the video game.
Oh. Bomber King, the video game. Alright, here's attempt number two. Dropping the bomb. That had a way shorter timer than I expected. Also, yeah. You start with like 20 bombs.
Well, you have to get around.
My shot's so short.
Well, hopefully nothing shoots too terribly far.
I'm nervous about this stuff.
Ow! Bombing.
Ow! That thing's just got loads of health.
Oh, so I said bombing.
Did my health go down all the way so far that I had to switch to a new energy deck? Is that what I'm reading here? It's a weird looking skull dude. Yeah, this is a lot like Bomberman. Oh, that's me. Hudson Soft's not Bomberman, is it?
Mm-hmm. No, I don't think so. Hey, smartphone.
Wikipedia. Bomberman. Yeah, Hudson Soft. This is just like... This is the people who made Bomberman just decided to make a campaign mode Bomberman. That's pretty cool.
This is probably before Bomberman?
I don't know. Bomberman goes back. Ha! What is that? Kevin?
No, it was like 1,000.
Oh. 1,000 points. Sweet. Yeah.
Double kill!
Who timed that perfectly?
I've been having a lot of random thoughts. Like, whenever you said our goal in this endeavor is, and I wanted you just to say, like, the Team Rocket anthem.
I don't know that I know the Team Rocket anthem.
Blasting off at the speed of light.
Meow.
That's right!
I got more time, but that doesn't actually show up anywhere, so I don't know what that means.
You have, like, oxygen, so you have to get out before your oxygen runs out. And if you get hit by a monster...
Oh, I can't go back!
If you get hit by, like, a monster, you lose... Did you just slide?
No. Those things look like Metroids inside.
These are actually baby Metroids? Surprise.
No. The Metroids that you usually see are baby Metroids.
These are extra baby
Metroids. Metroid 2.
That one just became
Return
a
of Samus. Yeah, it did. The Metroids start metamorphosizing. Into a bunch of crazy dangerous stuff. I'm just gonna keep bombing, and I mean, I guess I'm the king of bombing, right? Yeah.
You are the bomber king. You should go down.
Yeah.
Because there's a wall.
It's hard to get out of range of your bomb in time.
Well, he does a pretty cool slide thing. That's the bomb.
Cool. Your hiccups have gone worldwide.
Let's make it viral, people.
Yep, there's another dude that turned into a tree. He's another 1,000 points. That was the kanji for 1,000.
It's also like heaven? Is
no,
it?
No, heaven's different. It's I get them mixed up.
But
looks like we have a choice here. I'm gonna go the easiest way.
Isn't 1,000 multiple things? Like the kanji for 1,000, maybe?
I know that, like,
the
kanji for 1,000 is all, it's 1,000, but it's also something else, right?
What? I've been misled.
But I think I was just thinking of Chihiro, but I guess that is 1,000 still.
Yeah.
Ah, come on. Ah.
What is Hiro?
Drop
Chihiro?
Where I wanted
is
it.
1,000 dreams.
Could be. Yeah, I'm not sure.
One of my kid. I remember my kid was named Chihiro. Chihiro.
You want to try?
No, I'm slaying the watermelons. My hands.
Oh man, I want to eat some watermelon. Alright, I'm gonna try one more time. Then maybe this guy will try.
This guy?
We're going down to the surface of the alien planet.
Hey, Gord.
Yep.
There's a beer gardens tutorial in August.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like last year. Don't get anyone too drunk that they missed the.
No. That's just part of the fun.
If you can get someone to miss the orientation the next day.
Actually, I'm working during the orientation
the
next day.
So am I. Working during the orientation that day.
Nerds.
Okay. It's really fun. I really like running the workshops.
I don't want to run anything.
Gordon, since we probably want to go to the beer gardens, because hey, it's beer gardens.
Mm-hmm.
Shall we book a hotel room for that night?
That'd be cool. Ha! What the heck? Man, sweet, I can go in the water, but what's happening to my health bar? Oh, I'm dead. That's cool. Thanks, Bomber King. Thanks,
so,
BS Bomb. Yes, BS Bomb is shoot. And shout into the microphone is obscenities.
Ah! Curse the enemies, is that what you said?
I said obscenities.
Boo!
Basically the same.
You're the worst enemy ever, the enemy.
Joining us today from back home, hopefully, is the McMillans. And, you know, it's their fault that I'm into video games. There were these twins, and our parents would trade off babysitting, and we'd hang out. And they always had the coolest video games. And they're a couple years older than I am, so I was always looking up to them. And so I decided that video games were pretty cool. And here I am in Japan. You did it too!
But I clicked, like, I was going sideways and it made me slide backwards.
It's true. Yes, this game, the control is pretty tough. It's a tough game to, well, we could show our listeners that first 10 minutes of the game again, the first 2 minutes of the game again. Or we could switch to...
I'm actually gonna...
Star Assault! Yeah.
It was only my first try.
Yeah. But, like, I tried a bunch before that.
Yeah, but, like, I didn't get the controls down. Now I know, like, what I should do.
So, that one tree there, I tried twice in a row. The first time I got a power-up from it, and the second time I did not. So I think that power-ups from trees are just random. That's interesting.
I love those if you bomb yourself. You just die.
That looked like the spin jump power up from Metroid.
Okay, this is my last try.
Okay, I'm gonna look up. Oh, Bomberman is also called Dino Blaster in Europe.
Dino Blaster. Oh crap! That one is just dead.
Ah, 1983 was the first Bomberman. This is 1987, which is how old I am. So this game does not predate Bomberman. Bomber King, also called a Robo Warrior. Aw, looks like this one did get released in North America.
The creature was standing in my path, and it hit me back into my bomb.
Hmm. The player operates a cyborg named Zed, which stands for Zed-type Earth Defense. It's very Canadian.
I just want to get past this one.
Some gameplay elements resemble those of Bomberman 1983. I think that there's a reason for that, and it is because the guys who made Bomberman went on to make this game. Five level formats. Okay, a key for the time limit, some stuff, other stuff. Cool. All right. Robo Warrior. Where was it called? Robo Warrior. North America and Europe, I guess.
What? That's so dumb.
Yep. All right. Next game. Come on. Are you excited about Star Soldier? Star Soldier.
Star Soldier.
Star Soldier. Star Soldier. This is the one with the... No, this isn't even the one with the broken eject slide.
So I was looking up what to buy in Japan, like, because a lot of those articles are spooks, like surfacing on Facebook from all the jets that are coming in, and one was like things to buy in Japan, like necessary things, and on the list was Famicom.
Nice.
Really?
Yeah, it was like buy food. Buy clothes, so buy food, Famicom.
We saw in Okayama a Famicom that had the disc system built in, and I regretted not buying it. We almost went back. This is a prefecture or two over.
Hi, Gord's mom. I just saw your comment.
Hi, Nancy!
She said, hi, Andrew. Thanks for telling me.
Rah. Quick, tell a joke.
What did one wall say to the other wall? Meet you at the corner.
You gotta give me time.
What did one muffin say to the other muffin?
Ah, talking muffin.
I have a long joke I could tell you. Okay.
Is it a shaggy dog?
No. Do you want to hear a dirty joke?
No. This is...
Say yes.
Yes.
Kid jumps into a puddle.
Okay.
Do you want to hear the clean version? It takes a bath.
With bubbles?
Bubbles. So, there's four people on a plane and it's going down.
Holy crap. I ejected the cartridge halfway out, and that is what worked. Push the start button, high score, infinity. I guess it was zero. Ah, sweet. Galaga clone. Oh man, stuff is just off the top of the screen on the TV here. But I can see it fine over there. But there's a 500 millisecond delay.
Okay.
It's getting a little worried. Like, what? I mean. Sweet skulls, bro.
I don't
understand. Like, what kind of architecture can you hit? And. Weird. We've been burned by that in other games. Hang on.
It's like one of those moments where you're just like, what am I supposed to do?
There's another game they were playing where,
okay, so...
There were like two layers, and one layer you could fly over, but the other layer you'd just crash into, and there was not a great deal differentiating these visually. Oh, I didn't update the broadcast at all.
Stars. So if you go through a building, you can't shoot.
Oh, really?
Like when I go under a building, I can't shoot anymore.
Ah, get that. Yeah, you got it. What did it do?
Made me invincible.
Are you sure it made you invincible? Maybe it just made you bright. So in this one, the layer thing actually changes gameplay. What? There's some flashy stuff.
That's
stay away from that.
Ah! Zed! Get the Zed! Get the Zed! Oh, you missed the Zed. What? You almost found the boss.
I was so
close. Which looks like the invincibility, the overcharge.
I'm gonna try one more time.
Charge. Power up from Doom. Which is just this face floating in a blue bubble. Opening and closing its mouth. What was that thing? Is there like a canon explanation for what the heck that was?
It was like Andross from Star Fox.
Yeah.
Surprise!
Power-ups? Supercharge. From a soul sphere. Remember those guys?
No.
The Doom Bible notes that the soul sphere contains the life energy of a human soul.
That's interesting.
Cool.
Human souls.
Collecting it would award an extra life.
I've been watching Angel, so... What?
What happened?
When his mouth came together, it killed me.
Ha.
There's a lot of games I haven't played.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like, I was talking about how I haven't played Zelda.
There's definitely some Zelda games that... Get the Zed! Missed the Zed. There's some Zelda games that are worth playing, and that is the same set as the set of all Zelda games. Well, I mean, maybe don't play the ones on a CDI. An apparent prototype of Nintendo's first efforts with PlayStation. With Sony leaked. I'm pretty skeptical. Basically, it looks like an old external disk drive, which is to say, an old disk drive. It says Sony on the front with controller slots and a Super Famicom or European cartridge slot in the top. And, like, it had some yellowing, which added authenticity, but, I mean, you can just fake that.
Text our brain.
I don't know. I don't know if it's possible that they were far enough along to be coming up with physical prototypes.
What to do here?
Brain escaped. Way to go, man.
The brain.
What are you at?
I kept shooting him.
You can't let the brain escape. Come on.
I start over?
What happened on the blue face? Was that just a regular view?
I don't think so.
Huh. Oh, it's the same level, but with different dudes. Yeah, you got the Zed. Where did that... No, just bonus points.
Why are these guys following me? I can't believe I have to start at the beginning.
Well, it's basically a second level. The background's the same.
Oh, this is the exact same level.
Yeah.
Like the exact same buildings and stuff.
But the enemies are all different.
Sorry. But it is your turn.
I goofed. I think that's a sign that we should go on to the next game.
The next game.
And you know, we didn't plan this many games in advance, but we got a Super Game Boy. The bottom part you put into Super Famicom.
Super Famicom.
And into the top you put a Game Boy game. Now, we've got some Game Boy games here, a stack of them. That I just picked up. Some of these made it back to North America. Some of them were for nostalgia. Mostly my decision-making process is, hey, this looks like a weird thing that doesn't exist anywhere else. I'm going to put it on the show. And a funny feel. And Some of these were a dollar, so we grabbed them. Harvest Moon. This game actually fits on the show because the name is Bokujo Monogatari. The name of this show is Retro Monogatari. And that is the same Monogatari. And also, what the heck is this? What is this? Yamachan and Raymond, the Game Boy Color game. What's going on there? What are your expectations based on what you see?
Oh, hasuda.
And then
I don't even know. It just right? Says oha, 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 oha.
Was it like a? I think it was like a game show or something.
Maybe.
They kind of look like YTV hosts or something.
Yeah.
And there's Aretha. And the special thing about this game.
Did you say Aretha?
I said Aretha.
Franklin?
Is that the
Aretha Franklin?
The rivet in the back is loose, so let's pop it open. That's not why I bought it. I didn't realize it was like that. Oh, shoot. And then you drop the chip on the ground. Wow, look at that. That's pretty. So, it has a battery, so I'm assuming that it's got save game storage. Maybe that just became a standard thing that all games had.
Save game storage?
I mean, like, Kirby's Adventure didn't have save game storage. But you can beat that game in, like, I don't know, half an hour, 20 minutes? So, what should we play? I've got another stack of Game Boy games somewhere.
How about...
Oof. Well, this is the completed games box. It's getting heavier and heavier. We're completing a lot of games. Well, let's choose from this stack here. What do you think? Aretha?
Yeah.
Yeah, and how about Funny Field?
Yeah, Aretha Franklin and Funny Field.
Aretha and Funny Field. Two great tastes. So, we're going to go with Aretha. This might be hard to get back out, come to think of it, since the... No, I guess it slides. If it slides up, that won't be a problem. And... that in there. Switch the VCR channel. Wrong way.
Could you move the game?
Yes, there it is. Oh, it says there's no game.
It's burning up here in Japan.
And there we go. We've got
Super Game Boy.
Oh, actually, you know what? Another sweet purchase. Not even a purchase. The super friendly dude at the store just gave this to me. This turns one controller into a slot for four controllers. I'm gonna use that just to make my controller longer. And a sweet turbo controller. This stuff's magical. Just this ancient technology now. Andrew, tell us another joke. Clean one.
What?
A clean one.
Okay, so... who's a political woman figure that you don't like?
Shoot, I can't do that. A political woman, that's very specific.
Yes.
I feel like Sarah Palin is the obvious choice.
Okay, Sarah Palin. So there's four people on a plane.
It goes from player two through five.
I'm talking one.
Yeah.
So there's four people on a plane going down. Gord, Abraham Lincoln.
Oh, the game's up.
Thomas Edison.
No more joke.
And Sarah Palin. Remember that for the next break. Sarah Palin.
Opening start!
George Washington.
Load start.
Abraham.
Gosh. I don't think that I can use that controller extender for the first player.
What is this? Do you know what this game is?
I have no idea what this game is. Opening start!
It's in English. Nope.
Nope, definitely not in English.
Heishonaku aruse country.
Good.
That's not
English. Well, it gives us the credits at the beginning.
Ben, arukisto mo shuku. It's time!
The time.
And more opening credits.
The time is coming.
I wonder if there's something...
How long?
There's a gap in system here. If there's a reason that we're not getting the sound from the Super Famicom. I think it was fine with Chrono Trigger. Alright, exposition that we can't read because Andrew's looking at his phone.
I can't read it anyway. You're skipping to it too quickly.
Monster design. Graphic design.
Soshite. Tsugi the next day.
That, I didn't even skip that. That just jumped automatically.
Haruharu no machi. Haruharu no machi. This is the Haruharu town.
Haruharu town!
Freud.
Yeah, I'm playing. Hey, wow, does that ever look just like Final Fantasy Legend or Saga? Well, if you walk into a wall, it just slides you one way or another. It's like, oh, you must have meant this way.
Wakamono.
Understand thing?
Young thing?
Waka?
Waka mono.
Waka waka.
Wakai is young thing.
That goes too fast for me to be able to read it. So I'm looking for some combat to get an idea of what that would be like. Ah! Looks like we've got some random combats. There's a gnome wearing a Mega Man helmet.
It's literally it's a gnome.
It is a gnome.
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 Tadakai.
Attack.
Attack. Tokao, and then...
Totes attack. Rumble!
Tokao.
I took 1 damage, but he took 2 damage.
Let's go to Mamoru.
Protect?
No, that's Nigiri.
That's protect. Guard? Defend?
One thing I've noticed about old games is battles always take forever. Party ga zenmetsu shimashita. You dodge.
Alright. I'm going to... There. Yeah! Controller settings. Yeah, there we go. I don't have to set that every time, do I? Alright. So, as you can see, nothing is happening yet. Come on. I know that this works. Oh, wait. There we go. I should get the mouse and see if that. Woo! All right, here's the new challenge. I set up the screen and then you play.
I have to play through whatever you're doing.
Yeah.
You're like blacking out the screen.
Yep. Opening start. Now we got to go through the opening credits again.
There you go.
Yeah. It's one of the benefits to playing games on the Super Game Boy. Some games had a color palette information on the cartridge. So that even though the Game Boy was just black and white, so that we're totally frozen, are we? No, I think we're fine. We're fresh. Very fresh. The games would show up in color on the Super Game Boy. Some of them also had special borders that only that game would have.
Hotel! Love Hotel!
That's definitely what that says.
It's a Love All Hotel!
Right. I'm taking the, Wait, that wasn't it. What? Go back. Erase.
But what's the fun of that, Mom? Tadaima. Menshitsu desu. What's menshitsu? It's like something office?
Menshitsu? It's a noodle room.
Oh, yeah.
In the Love Hotel? There's a noodle room in the Love Hotel?
Of course.
It says, welcome home.
Mochidon.
It says, Tadaima, I'm home at the noodle place. She lives in a noodle place.
Cool. All right, I'm going to see if I can buy some loot. Well, there's a 3-9. Is this based on a...
Wait, was I right?
It's based on a...
Oh, gosh. No. We don't know.
Okay. We've just decided that
decided that she lives in a noodle.
Buy something, will you?
The noodle office.
We have 0 peta, and we need 32,000 peta in order to get a...
Cup.
Grip? Grip. Alright, I'm gonna...
Kiapu.
How do I get money without getting into fights that kill me and make me have to go through the opening credits again? It's a big town. No do shop? Soto shop? Sword shop. Sword shop! Man, katakana is weird.
Soto shop.
Soto shop.
Irasshai ni
yoru. Yeah, give me a sword, but I can't pay for it. Bojani button. Why is that in English?
Kaimasen. Well, because you really are trying to buy something, and like, what are you doing?
I don't have
they must not be Japanese.
I don't have any money. What's this say? What? Did I just find an ATM machine with a whole bunch of money in it? I apologize for saying ATM machine. Did I just find an ATM with a bunch of money? Yes, take it all. Take it all.
It's like
give me
balance,
all of the money.
Right?
There's a game, the game that Link's Awakening on the Game Boy is based on, is called For the Frog, the Bell Tolls. And 10,000 I can get this. What is this? Mango Shoe?
Mango Shoe?
Hand axe. What's a mango shoe?
Mango shoe.
Oh, I'm gonna buy it, I guess.
Mango shoe.
All right, I'm gonna put a mango on my shoe, on my foot.
Mango shoe.
Anyway. Crap.
Mango.
You are the You're a prince. You're the prince of the frogs. And
Dare ni statsu weapon sodo madori.
Yeah, mango shoe.
Mango shoe.
Since you are a prince, you are just magnificently wealthy. And every time in the game, which is apart from that, your typical action RPG. You'll just like call up a servant or whoever to bring money out of storage, and your money counter goes from zero to like
skeleton and gnome.
The integer cap.
Skeleton and a gnome.
Skeleton and a gnome. Well, let's see if that sword
Dare?
There's a cat to show who I'm going to attack. Yeah, attack the skeleton. And also, the skeleton is wearing a Mega Man helmet.
The skeleton did for them 13 damage.
Sweet. Do you think it was a critical hit?
I don't know. It went too fast. I can't read it. I can't read it like that.
I have 6 HP.
We only had like 10 to begin with. So.
Yay!
Treasure! Arimasu! Futo! Futa! Oh! Agemasuka?
Doshimasuka?
Ishikoro koro.
Koro koro.
Koro koro.
Oh crap, I gotta do another thing. Oh, no.
Ane-san, it's your older sister.
Or a girl who is just older than you.
Older girl. Ane-san.
Japanese is weird. Wonder if I can get any more money out of that ATM.
Monster.
Oh man, I don't think I can survive this unless I get another critical hit.
I don't think you got critical hits. I think you just do 14 damage.
Yeah? With my mango shoe.
14 no damage.
Oh, yeah. That was pretty good. And now he's going to hit me for...
2 damage.
Yep. Yeah. Sweet. I can do this. Oh, he's still alive.
Yeah.
Right, he started with 20.
20. So now he's dead. Yay!
Maybe I'll find another mango shoe, and then I'll have a pair.
Futao! Nakawa! I can't read it.
I
don't know what you get.
I have no patience for this. I'll go back to the ATM.
You want to go to health?
Yeah, eventually. I think this game might be a little beyond our scope. Should I buy another mango shoe?
I mean, why? You already have them.
You got 2 feet.
I don't think that's what it was.
Oh, jeez. Everything here is so expensive.
You can buy a goodie boot.
What? What? Goodie what boot. Even? Alright. Is there an option here for sound settings? No, just controller, huh? I'm wondering why I can't hear anything. There we go.
I'm sorry. I just opted me to go into Super Mario. It's gonna happen.
That is me. I have 2 HP. But I went into this place and they kicked me out.
Gomen. Boku wa wakara. Wakara. Wakara nai nda. He doesn't understand. I don't understand.
I'm hurt. Heal me.
I don't understand. Ding, 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 ding,
all right, I'll go to the hotel. いらっしゃいませ. Heiwa.
This is the hotel music.
おいてます. Does it cost 10,000 to heal? Yeah, it looks like it costs 10,000 to heal in the noodle room. Also, I'm not sure if that's what that means.
This is the outside world music.
Man, I can't walk behind this tree. What? That was a fight? I just wanted to talk to that guy. Quick, sing the Castle Crashers music. Yes, open it. Like, how, what? Who would say no? Is there, like, a cost that I'm missing?
Might open a minute.
There we go. Now I'm talking to that dude. But I can't understand him, so I'm gonna walk right on by. You're right, it might be a mimic. I don't think it's going to be a mimic. Monsta! It looks like he's holding a football helmet under his arm. Did I just do a 15? That's not bad. Do I level up? Yay, 200 peta. I need like 8,000% of that to heal 6 HP. Dump truck? Is this the dump truck song?
Dump truck. It's really hard being a video game music person.
Yep. All right, let's switch to the next game. That was Aretha.
Franklin.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to do one more thing.
For Aretha Franklin.
Yes, for Aretha Franklin. I'm going to load start and see where this guy left off.
Where did
status? There's still only one person.
Level 5.
50 HP.
I don't think it's like a team game. I think it's just a team game.
But like, why would Stan? Do you think it was just built on an engine that was made for team games?
Oh, maybe.
All right, we're now playing the save file belonging to the previous owner.
It's a fairy.
70 HP.
You're killing the fairy.
I think I dealt 20 damage.
You only had 5 HP.
And then I died. Thanks, previous owner.
Probably why he sold it, because he kept dying.
All right, we're playing Funny Field next.
Funny Field, Funny Field, Funny Field.
Did you just take a picture of Funny Field?
Take a picture of my nose.
Cool.
As I was chewing on the funny face. Why is this a music? I don't know any more music. Darn, darn, darn. I should have done more of a, instead of the kind of Pokemon-esque, I should have done more Final Fantasy.
Well, to find out if it's a problem with the Super Famicom, I'm going to put in Chrono Trigger.
Well, didn't it just play?
If this doesn't give us music, then something's wrong.
It shouldn't be
like... Yeah, it definitely should. Should definitely be hearing some sound here. Excuse me, Super Famicom? Why aren't you making noises?
First, let me take a selfie.
Okay,
so there's 4 people. Sarah Palin, Gord, Abraham Lincoln,
And?
Alexander Graham Bell.
Okay.
So, plane's going down. There's only 3 parachutes. Oh no, only 3 people can get a parachute. Abraham Lincoln's like, I was a president. So I get a parachute. So he grabs a parachute and jumps out. Sarah Palin says, well, I'm, you know, the most important woman. I'm so smart. I should get a parachute because, you know, I'm going to lead the country and everything's going to be great with me. So she grabs a parachute and jumps out. And Alexander Graham Bell looks at you and he's like, there's only one parachute left. And he's like, I'm old. I should have died years ago. I technically did. But you grab the parachute. You're young and you're going to survive. What does Gord say?
Don't worry, Sarah Palin took my backpack.
Good, don't worry, Sarah Palin took my backpack.
Nice.
And then you both get a parachute and jump in.
Yay!
Yes!
Alright, so.
Have you heard that one before?
Yeah.
I love
that one. Except Gord's a little boy in that one.
Thanks.
I like to tell the story, like, with the person in it. They seem more engaged that way.
Good teacher. I'm making a peanut butter banana chocolate smoothie.
Sweet. Yay!
Sweet.
You should make peanut butter watermelon smoothies.
No.
Alright, so I think for the time being, what I'm going to do...
No.
What even do I... Is this a GameCube?
Dun, dun. Dun,
so
dun,
the,
dun,
the front
dun.
Inputs on the VCR, which I got to act as a demodulator for the Famicom, which only has coax output. The front inputs for... Oh, what the heck? Oh, that's weird. Anyway, some things are messed up. And it's not getting the audio. Can I even reach this? No, I don't think I can. What do we do? What do we do?
Baby.
I think we just play without sound for now. sure why that would be doing that. It's definitely part of the experience, though, right? Oh, now it just works. All right. Let's just play Chrono Trigger. Is that all right? Can we just play Chrono Trigger? Get some of that glare off. All right, Andrew, you got to play the next game. So that I can eat some watermelon.
I'm taking care of
we got a show to do. Ta-da!
Well, it has to work before I can play.
Ta-da! Ta-da! Ta-da!
You know what to do.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
I think Whitey Snake doesn't watch me.
Yeah. This is, not something you should ever do, but it's super satisfying. That's the kind of experience that we have to offer here at Retro Monogatari. Look at that first try! Alright, let's do this. Super Game Boy! Funny Field! There is a start, and that's the only option. Hey, this goes multiplayer. What? Alright. Round one. Whoa, is this like Sokoba? Cool. All right. I won. This is like combat Sokoba. Oh, crap. No! Go back in there. Yeah, two at once. Now what do I do with that guy? I can't pull this, can I? Oh.
The baby is okay.
This is Combat Sokoban Othello?
Hey,
all right, I'm testing a theory.
Caught, bunker. You don't even know what you're grabbing.
Crap. I think what you can do is, yeah, and then.
You see the picture on Facebook?
What?
Peter, Peachy's with Peter right now.
I think it's gonna be your turn soon. So you can flip tiles, and if you do so while a dude is on it, it's like every tile between you and another tile. Like, that didn't do what I wanted it to. Let's try this. That froze him, now I get to run around and maybe push a block into him, but I don't know. Funny Field. Hey, William.
He's praying right now.
Dancing. There's continue. Also, that was two-player, but... Oh, one-player multi. One-player versus two-player. Okay, this must be the kind of thing we've got to be plugged in by cable. Those songs aren't super different. Ready? Careful, that's as far as it goes. The,
well, what's I'm doing?
Controller cable.
What do I do?
Push those blocks.
Oh, I push a block.
Oh, maybe you can't. Yeah, I have no idea. But I'm gonna eat some watermelon!
Can you eat some watermelon with the baby?
No. Babies can't eat watermelon.
Ah! I understand.
Maybe you just have to get all of the monsters on the screen to done. Yeah, like if you flip this tile, and then a tile horizontally or vertically across from it, all the tiles in between will flip. Yeah. I think it only stuns monsters when it turns from white to orange. Oh, that's good.
Yay!
Oh, you just have to turn it all orange.
Oh, you didn't realize that?
Nope, not at all.
It's a lot harder than you think with this baby.
Watermelon! Oh, you're almost there. Haha! Nice.
This is baby!
Yeah, he's super disruptive, hey?
Baby, I'm trying to play a game.
Baby, yeah, William. This is serious business.
Baby doesn't care. Baby likes to see the world. This baby wants to see the world burn.
You're definitely a whole bunch better than me at this game already.
I think I played you. This crab. Baby, I'm trying to play a game. Can you guys see I'm on round 4 right now?
His old memory.
I think I played a game like this. I don't quite know what it was. Oh, I can push the blocks.
Yep, you can. Well, sweet. You can completely knock out the monsters with those blocks if you trap them in a spot where they can't escape.
Ah, see, they flipped that one on me.
Ah.
They're too quick. Ah, baby!
Ha.
I'm trying to keep him from, like... he's grabbing my finger and I can't press the button.
We were at the McMillan's. And there was watermelon on the table. And my mother was putting salt on her watermelon. And that was the first time I'd ever heard of anyone doing that. And I decided that I would not be the sort of person to put salt on his watermelon. That's just weird.
I'm so pissed. This ghost over here is pointing.
Take those blocks and squish them against the wall.
I can't do anything because William the baby keeps grabbing my fingers.
Yeah. But he's so cute.
Look at the camera. Look at you.
Look at Spew.
I'm William and I'm dancing.
He seems so mellow now. He was not mellow earlier. It was a rough afternoon. Wasn't it, William?
Did you see this? We just pushed the comm into it.
Yeah. Does that mean the crazy is coming out?
Yeah. It's 9 o'clock!
Yeah, we're done.
Say bye, William. Bye-bye!
This has been another episode of Retro Monogatari. This hand is covered in watermelon. Games are we gonna play next week?
We're gonna play some games.
Yeah. Yeah. Which ones?
The ones that you put into a Famicom.
Yeah.
And you press power, and make start. And then you play them with like a controller or something. And then like, there's like an element of the game where you have to do something.
Happy ending! Peanut butter chocolate banana smoothies!
Cheers!
I'm cheersing, but I have a baby hat.
Oh yeah. I'll put it here.
He tries to hand me the drink and I'm like, I have no hands.
But I must scream. Alright.
Baby.
Are we going to play Game Boy games or are we going to play Famicom games?
We're going to play Alice in Wonderland. The Dingy Ding.
Good.
I don't think that we're going to play that.
We're going to play this game. Not really. I don't know what this is. It looks really cool though.
We played that on an episode.
What is this?
It's an RPG. Back before all of the tropes were in place that made RPGs good. Alright, let's play these two.
Yeah!
Yeah! We've got a Momotaro game, Peach Boy Legend. That's a local legend where a boy was born out of a peach. And then he goes on some adventures and he gives...
You have
dumplings to... No, he gives mochi. Mochi?
Chibidongo. Oh, it's Momotaro.
Yeah.
Well, my kid would be so happy.
Yeah, he gives mochi to a bunch of animals, and they decide to join him. This is good, thank you. And
you have Golden Sun Dark Dawn.
What is this?
This is...
Futaru?
Futaru! It says foreigner. He's a foreigner.
Foreigner Futaru. Well, maybe we'll be able to understand it. And we might throw in some bonus Game Boy games. Just for kicks.
Bonus
is that something we can
kicks.
Do now?
Do you have Chrono Trigger in English?
Cheers. I have Chrono Trigger so many different ways. Let's talk Chrono Trigger.